If you are an active Snapchat user, you know that there are fun little geo filters you can overlay on top of your videos and your pictures in Snapchat in order to kind of personalize it and decorate it a little bit. Well, today I want to show you how you can create your own custom geo filters and how to submit them to Snapchat for you to use on your videos and pictures at the locations that you designate. That's coming up. Hey guys, my name is Tim Schmoyer and it's Wednesday, which means it's time to give you guys a little bit of an online video tip. Today I want to talk about Snapchat because for those of you who are developing your YouTube channels and your audiences or just generally speaking online, especially if you are a personality type of brand and channel or blog or podcast or whatever, Snapchat can be an awesome tool for you to keep your audience engaged with relatively little effort on your part. I've been playing with Snapchat a lot, especially on the video side, and it really just has become an amazing tool for connecting, staying in touch with fans and followers and keeping them engaged and providing more value to them, lots of awesome stuff. What I want to talk about today are the custom geo filters that Snapchat has and how to make one. I'm going to take you to my desktop because you need to do this from your computer, and then you also need to submit it to Snapchat through your computer as well. Let's head to my desktop. I am just at snapchat.com. This is what you see when you get here. Down at the bottom, click this little arrow, and right here under community, click on geo filters. And what this is going to let you do is submit one. So once it loads, you'll see some of the other ones other people have created and submitted. Just click on this, let's do it right in the middle. Here are the guidelines that you need to follow for the dimensions. And so if you're using Photoshop or PicMonkey, this is what you're going to enter in as a transparent, this is really important, transparent PNG image, 1080. Is going to be the width, and 1920 is going to be the pixels. Basically 1080p resolution flipped edgewise on the side. Make sure you leave 149 pixels at the top and the bottom as buffer. Don't put anything over there. And then also they say to avoid the borders, don't wrap something all the way around. You can put something around the sides if you want, but don't wrap it all the way around. The other submission guidelines, it basically tells you you can't use any logos and you can't have any artwork on it other than what you have created originally all by yourself. Can't use anyone else's work or images or anything like that. All original material. So it's going to come to the map, and I want to do one of the airport. I live in Cincinnati. I fly in and out of the airport a lot. So you're just going to click to draw borders around the area where you want this snap code to work, to show up on people in Snapchat for people. So I'm just going to say, hey, I would love to have one every time I come to Cincinnati Airport. So I'm just going to make it like that, click it, and then you can right click on corners if you want to undo them. So if I could undo that one, happen, but I'm just going to drag it back like that. So that's basically the area where I want this snap code to appear. Then come over to upload your images, and I've created this one right here. And I made a little one, a little airplane, welcome to Cincinnati CVG Airport. You're going to type in your name and your email, why this location is meaningful to you, any additional notes you want to say about it. This is not an event, so if it was one for a specific event, you know, like a concert or something, maybe you would want to uncheck that. And then make sure it's all your original work, does not create any trademarks or logos, and that you agree to the terms of service. Click the I'm not a robot, and then click submit. What'll happen next is that it will upload and submit that image that you created to Snapchat, and they'll take, you know, sometimes a few days, sometimes a few weeks to check it out and approve it. You will get an email confirmation telling them right after you submit it, one saying yes, we received it, and then you will also get an email confirmation again later after they've approved it. I'd love to hear from you guys if you've ever created any custom geo filters for Snapchat, what your experience with it has been like. If you have any good tips for how to create geo filters that are more likely to be approved, definitely leave those comments down below as well. As well as tell me what you think about Snapchat as a whole for using it for your YouTube audience development or your blog or your podcast or however you're developing your audience. I found it to be an extremely valuable tool, and I'll be talking more about that here. But in the meantime, comments below if you're interested in Snapchat. Read what other people are saying down there, and I know you will learn a lot from them. If this is your first time here, I'd love to have you subscribe. Usually we talk about YouTube audience development, but generally overall, this is a channel for video creators, including Snapchat video creators, as I am becoming one myself. This channel really revolves around helping you grow your audience so that your message spreads and reaches the people who need to hear what you have to say and hopefully have their lives be changed as a result of that. So thank you for hanging out with us here a little bit. Subscribe, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow. Bye.